And also, we want to say good morning to those of you that are coming in by way of Facebook Live. Good morning to those of you that are or that will watch the replay. And to those of you that will start watch parties, we want to say good morning to you. To those of you that are joining us on Facebook and prayer line at 917-900-1022, access code 892-3928. For connecting with other intercessors through this fourth hour prayer watch at 5 a.m. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and we shall rejoice in it and be glad. Good morning, Sister Steph, Sister Kia, Sister Kim, Sister Janice, Sister Magna, Sister Teresa, Sister Janice, good morning. Good morning to you, Sister Shelley, Mother Bowers, Sister Kathleen, good morning and praise the Lord. Good morning, Sister Brenda. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Shirley, Sister Lisa. Amen. We made it to the end of another weekend. Thank you, Jesus. Good morning, Sister Arinda, Sister Doris. Good morning, Sister Elma. Good morning, Sister Dewana. Good morning, Brother Adrian. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Denise, Sister Sarah, Sister Jessie, Sister Angela. Good God morning. Amen. Good morning, Sister Steph, and praise the Lord. Good morning, Sister Veronica, Sister Patty, Sister Lorette, Sister Wanda, Sister Theola, Sister June, Sister Cherry, good morning. Sister Teresa, Sister Kimberly, good morning. Sister Teresa, Sister Wanda, and good morning, Brother Clark. Good morning, Sister Ida, Sister Ada, Lady Susan, Sister Janice, Sister Wilhelmina, good morning. Sister Teresa, Sister Carol, Sister Deborah, Sister Judith, good morning. Good morning, Sister Vanessa. Good morning, Sister Betty. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Erica. Praise the Lord. And good morning, Sister Nona, Sister Dania, Mother McCroy. Good morning. Good morning, Sister Belinda, Sister Dion. Good morning. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Shirley, Sister Mary, and Sister Mary. Good morning, Sister Deborah. God bless you. Good to see you. Good morning, Sister Monica. Good morning, Elder Dial. Good morning, Sister Gwendolyn. Sister Crystal. Good morning, Sister Tanya. Sister Cassandra. Sister Beth. Good morning. Good morning, my sister Trish. Good morning. Good morning. I'm going to ask those of you that are coming in by way of Facebook Live, if you could do me a favor and push the share button so that your community can pray with you this morning. Good morning and praise the Lord, Minister Gary, Sister D, Brother Sean, good morning, God bless you. Good morning, Dr. Hampton. Good morning, Sister Donna, God bless you, God bless you. We want to make sure that our community is in prayer with us this morning, wherever they may be. Come to prayer. Praise the Lord and good morning, Brother Kenneth. Let's make ourselves a committee of one to make sure our community is in prayer. Good morning, Sister Catherine. Good morning, Sister Catherine. Dr. Longmire, Sister Marietta, Sister Giovanna, Sister Cheryl, Sister Denise. God bless you. And for those whose names that we cannot see, we want to welcome you to prayer this morning and a word. Listen, I want to share with you to make sure that we're all aware that for any reason that there is any kind of technical difficulty on the Facebook Live. Good morning, Sister Ruthie. Good morning, Sister Marva. Sister Marianne, good morning. If there's any technical difficulty on Facebook Live, just go immediately over to the prayer line at 917-900-1022. Access code 892-3928. Good morning, Sister Dewana. Good morning, Sister Lauren. Yes, thank God for the brothers. Good morning, Brother Larry, Sister Monica, Sister Roxanne. I want to thank also those of you that have been sowing into Krista Tyson Ministries at Cash App $ Krista M. Tyson. Thank you so much for sharing and for sowing. Good morning, Pastor Burrell, Sister Darlene, Sister Trina. I'm inviting all of you to join me on Saturday mornings at 5 a.m. Eastern Time for Early Rising Bread. You can join me on Facebook and on the prayer line. If you would like to, those of you that are coming in by way of Facebook Live, If you would like to strategically intercede with your hands and fingers in this hour to command, direct, and prophesy into the mornings of others for positive outcomes based upon the word of God, you're welcome to do so by positioning yourselves as you're coming in and sharing in the prayer and sharing in the word of the Lord. Good morning, Sister Cassinda, Sister Betty, Sister Carol, praise the Lord. And Minister Hayes, praise the Lord and good morning. Good to see you. The word of God declares unto us that death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. So we declare what the Bible declares this morning, and that is that I will make my prayer unto God, and he will hear me. And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he hear us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desired of him. So let's go into the word of the Lord. As I share with you this directive word this morning, and just before we go into prayer, the Lord is impressing upon me to deal with kingdoms colliding. Kingdoms colliding. We visit this passage from the book of Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 12. And it reminds us that for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. I want you to declare with me this morning, this thing is spiritual. This thing is spiritual. We have to keep this before us so that we don't get caught up in hands-on battle or hands-on combat. But we must remember that what we are seeing in the earth, what we are experiencing in the land, it is spiritual. I have to say this, that in my lifetime, I do not believe that I have ever seen and felt the signs of the adversary so clearly trying to cross boundaries, declaring war, and blurring the lines of right and wrong. It reminds me so much of a song that we used to sing when we were children, that I used to hear our forefathers and mothers sing. We're living in the last days. They're saying that wrong is right. They're saying that right is wrong. And that's also in the word of God. We're living in the last days. And the children of God are not being removed from the ramifications of it. The children of God are in the middle of feeling the after effect and the effect of what's going on within the world. But God has left us in the center of it for a reason. Have you ever questioned and wondered why that God still has you here at this time? There is a reason that God has you here at this time. We must pray now like we have never, hear me, church. We must pray now like we have never prayed before. It is no more business as usual. We would love to see things return to what we consider to be normal. What was our norm is no more. Follow me, church. That we considered to be normal is no more. Sometimes we have to repeat this in our own heads, in our own minds, that what was our norm is no longer the norm. I shared in a message some time ago of God speaking to me concerning kingdoms colliding. And the same notification he shares again. There are two kingdoms or realms that influence and that operate within the earth. One that is which you can see, whose philosophies, power, influence is from the prince of the power of the air, whose name is Satan. The blood of Jesus. Let's get this clear. The power that he has, the power that he has comes from God, and he cannot act without permission. He is not a free agent where he just does things. He has to have permission. If we remember from the book of Job, the Bible speaks to the fact when Satan presented himself along with the sons of God, remember this, that he had to ask for permission before he did anything. Remember that when anything has to ask for permission, it does not have full authority and full control. If you remember, we talked about a couple days ago that the heavens do rule. The enemy, our adversary, does not have free course without the permission of God. So the power that he has comes from, he got that permission from God. While God remains to be sovereign and without an equal, he has given Satan boundaries to operate within. But Satan seeks to expand those boundaries. Hear me, church. So even the power of this natural kingdom comes from the spiritual. The other kingdom is a spiritual one. A spiritual one you cannot see, whose power and authority rests totally in God. The child of God is a resident of both kingdoms. The kingdom here on earth and the kingdom of God. And the child of God, being a resident of both kingdoms, must understand. Church, I feel this, the necessity of us praying now more than ever before. We're in the resident of both kingdoms and must understand that the power and authority of and from the ruler, the King, the Sovereign Lord, is the power and authority in the hands of the child of God to live in both realms. And the Bible says, and ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Paul describes the two kingdoms as warring against each other. This is an old battle. I'm going to say that again. This is an old battle. It is an old war between God and Satan. Satan has been trying to have authority, has been trying to be omnipotent for ever since he was. Trying to be omniscient and omnipresent. He is not. The natural yet seeks to prevail over the spiritual. It's the mentality that came from its father that is ruling in the nation today. Its power says, I will ascend into heaven and I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the cloud. I will be like the Most High. The blood of Jesus within this natural and spiritual hostile environment. The child of God is told to live and to proclaim the wondrous works of God. So here lies the reason for the colliding of the two kingdoms. Paul wants to make it clear that what you are wrestling with, what you are fighting with, is not human, it's spiritual. You must find the pressure point of the enemy and drive prayer on it. Hallelujah. Oh God, Paul said, we're wrestling principalities. We're wrestling territories that are ran by an evil spirit. We're wrestling with powers of darkness, ranking fallen angels. These evil spirits exercise influence over people. These evil spirits are exercising influence in geographical areas. Hear me, church. These evil spirits are exercising influence in cities. They're exercising influence in the nation. They're exercising influence in the land. They're exercising influence in high positions, in areas, in the earth, in authority. And we must address it in the spirit. We must address it in the spirit. Take your mouth, your natural mouth, off of it and go in the spirit and address it. Go in the spirit. Can you imagine what would happen if not only a few of us, but if we bombard heaven concerning the spirit that is running rampant in the earth in today, in the name of Jesus? Yes, we understand that there are intercessors 24 hours of the day, and it is a wonderful thing what God has done. God has, in the name of Jesus, God has given time zones, and in the time zones there was somebody praying in every time zone, which means that there was somebody praying and interceding 24 hours of the day, interceding, bombarding heaven for what's going on in our nation and in our world today. We must get the children of every child of God that you know that is not praying, that is not pushing on heaven, that is not calling on the kingdom, calling on God. We must encourage them. This, as never before, it's time for us to pray. This is not time for us to play. This is not time for us to play Christianity. This is not the time for us to try to impress each other, trying to make others believe that we are where we are not. But this is the time that we need to call upon God. It matters not what your prayer sounds like. It matters not if you can put together big words or little words. It doesn't matter. Just talk to God. We must address this thing in the spirit. Hey, God. Hallelujah. So we get ready to go into prayer in the name of Jesus. We already know we got to cover this thing. If we never covered a prayer in thanksgiving and in worship and in praise on this morning, we got to do that. Cover it, cover it, cover it, cover. Sandwich it with praise. Sandwich it with the understanding of who God is. Sandwich it with the name of Jesus, with the power and the authority of the name of Jesus. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, before we pray for it, and before we pray concerning the kingdom collision, oh God, that is happening in the earth. We send up praise. Hallelujah. We send up worship. Oh God, we acknowledge, Lord God, your presence. We acknowledge, dear God, that you are the supreme power. We acknowledge, dear God, the authority that you have in the earth, that you are in control of all things. And God, we lift your name on high this morning. Father, you sit on the circle of the earth, and you see all things, and you know all things. And God, we give you glory. We give your name praise. We acknowledge, dear God, that from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, we acknowledge, dear God, we acknowledge the fact. In the name of Jesus, come on, sandwiches. You are God Almighty. Hallelujah. You are the creator, yeah, of heaven and of earth. Come on, praise him. You are before all things, and by you all things consist. Father, we acknowledge the fact that from everlasting, Lord God, you are the first and the last. He who was dead but now is alive forevermore. Father, we acknowledge the fact and we praise the fact that you are the sovereign God. Hallelujah. Oh God, and in you we live, and in you we move, and in you we have our being. We saturate, dear God, we saturate our atmosphere and surround this prayer, Lord God, with your presence. Father, omnipresent God, you feel all space. Oh, you are God. You always was. You always will be. Ah, God. You always will be God. You are our strength. And God, for this we give you praise. You are our shield. And for this, dear God, we give you praise. And in this, God, do we put our trust. In you, dear God, do we put our hope. Father, let nothing in the name of Jesus, nothing in our lives stand between our petition, Lord God, and your answer in the name of Jesus. So, Father, we ask that you will forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And God, create within us a clean heart, oh God, and renew a right spirit within us in the name of Jesus. And we declare that it is so in the name of Jesus. Oh God, hallelujah. Here we lay before you our petition. Father, in the name of Jesus, since you are the omniscient God, knowing all things before they happen, while it has happened, and you know the end of the thing, Father, the natural and the spiritual battle that is existing in the earth, we pray, Lord God, can only be addressed in the spirit, so we cloak ourselves. Hallelujah. So we dress ourselves before we enter in to praying for Lord God in the spirit, in the name of Jesus. We put on the whole armor of God. Ha, God, we dress our feet in the name of Jesus. We dress our feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Father, we take the shield of faith, hallelujah, to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. Father, we put on the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And God, we pray, 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 pray always with prayer and supplication in the Spirit. And your word declares, in watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Father, in the name of Jesus, And we pray with thanksgiving that the peace of God, hallelujah, which transcends all understanding, will guard our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Oh, Father, we plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. Hey, God, we plead the blood of Jesus. Set a watch, dear God, around us in the name of Jesus. Oh God, suckle us in with your blood and with your name, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, we pray, dear God, for a wall of protection. Our God, a wall of protection around your people, in the name of Jesus. Put a wall of protection, a covering, dear God, around your people. Oh God, for what's on the horizon, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, I pray a covering. I pray, Lord God, that you preserve your people, in the name of Jesus. I pray, dear God, that you shield your people, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, I pray that you keep the children of God in this season, in the name of Jesus. Keep them, Lord God, with their mind stayed upon you. Keep them, Lord God, running after you in the name of Jesus. Oh God, may the children of God never let go of your hand. May they remain faithful in the name of Jesus. Father, may the children of God, may they recognize the signs of your working hand. Father, in the name of Jesus, may they recognize and respond to your promptings of preparation in this season, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, may they respond to your promptings in the name of Jesus to prepare themselves in this season. Father, in the name of Jesus, prompt the children of God, prompt the children of God, just as you didn't keep your mind from Abraham. Father, prompt them that this is not business as usual. Oh God, if the business before was to eat, drink, and to be merry, then the business now is to fast, pray, and to look up more than ever before. Oh God, when you see these signs, when you see the day approaching, when you see what's on the horizon, look up for your redemption draweth nigh. The coming of Christ is nearer than we think, in the name of Jesus. So Father, hallelujah, we pray, dear God, for mass repentance among the children of God. You said, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, and turn, oh God, turn in the name of Jesus. Turn, turn. Oh, Father, may we be ready for the hour that we think not that you are coming, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, we speak life, life over every child of God that is depressed, life over every child of God that is oppressed, life, Lord God, over every child of God that is suppressed. Father, in the name of Jesus, we declare over them that what you have said, nay, in all of these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Oh God, for we are persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Come on, pray, church. Father, we lay before you and we pray for our nation in the name of Jesus. We pray for our land. Oh God, Lord, have mercy. Oh God, have mercy in the name of Jesus. Have mercy, God. Hallelujah. Oh Father, Father, we pray. We pray concerning the spirit of unrest that is in the land, dear God. We hear the groaning in the earth. We hear the moaning in the earth. In the name of Jesus, it's ringing in our ears. Oh, Father, have mercy in the name of Jesus. The groanings, Lord God, are coming out in violence. The groanings, Lord God, are coming out in injustice. The groanings, Lord God, are coming out in division. It's coming out, dear God, in the lack of order. It's coming out, dear God, in those in authority, out of authority. Oh, Father, it's coming out in destruction. It's coming out in lives that are lost or being lost, lives that are taken, and there is no earthly justice. Oh, God, the groaning is coming out. And Father, we pray for peace. Oh, God, we pray for peace and justice. Father, in the name of Jesus, have mercy. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we pray, dear God, we pray concerning our economy. We pray, Lord God, for the sickness and disease that is on the rise. Father, in the name of Jesus, may we, even as children of God, practice wisdom, wisdom with knowledge in the name of Jesus. We pray, dear God. Oh, God. Hallelujah. COVID seems to be what's on the rise. But Father, in the name of Jesus, oh, God, you're able, oh, God, to heal it all and to stop it all. Father, have mercy. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, hallelujah, we pray. Pray for families. Families, Lord God, that are separated by the disease. Father, they can't come together. Loved ones in the hospital, they can't visit, Lord God. They can't be with them, Father, in the name of Jesus. Families, Lord God, hallelujah. Oh, God, may you be, Lord God, hallelujah, the love and the clue that keeps them together, even during this time, in the name of Jesus. We pray, dear God, essential workers that are being infected and affected, and their families, Lord God, being challenged in the name of Jesus. Father, give and restore life in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, Father, in your name, we pray concerning wickedness in high places. Father, in the name of Jesus, raise up, Lord God, raise up a strong consciousness. Raise up, Lord God, an undeniable and an unshakable guilt and repentance in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, give those that are in authority, those that operate without regard to right, oh, God, give them no rest. Give them no rest, dear God, till they come to repentance. Father, in the name of Jesus, confuse behind the door conversations. Father, raise up a voice of right in the midst of, to speak truth to the powers that be. Father, hallelujah, have mercy in the name of Jesus. have mercy. Oh God, no matter, Lord God, what side of the election, Father, no matter what side, Father, bring it all to right in the name of Jesus. May there, Lord God, be a consciousness of right on both sides in the name of Jesus. Father, your word declares, hallelujah, hallelujah, the God of Israel said, the rock of Israel spake, he that ruleth over men must be just, hallelujah, ruling in the fear of God. Father, in the name of Jesus, raise up an internal fear, raise up a reverence for you in the name of Jesus. Father, your word declares that righteousness exalteth a nation, but sin, Lord God, hallelujah, is a reproach to any people. Hey, Father, hallelujah, let the clouds rain down righteousness. Hallelujah, let the earth open that salvation and righteousness may bear fruit. Oh God, let the earth cause them both to sprout. Oh God, I, the Lord, have created it in the name of Jesus. Father, let not the people of God be blinded by anything that they see, blinded, dear God, by anything that they hear that will not allow them to hear you in the name of Jesus. Oh God, open up their ears, spiritual ears, more than ever before. Father, open our eyes in the name of Jesus. Father, hallelujah, thy kingdom come. Oh God, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, I ask you, God, hallelujah, to give your people wisdom, Lord God. Give them knowledge in the name of Jesus in what they do, in every move that they make, in how they spend, in how they live, in how they exist, in what, Lord God, their needs are, and what, Lord God, is just a desire. Father, in the name of Jesus, make us more aware than ever before of where we are and what time it is. Father, in the name of Jesus, and into your hand, Lord God, we declare and decree and believe, hey God, hallelujah, and it is so in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we declare, Lord God, that mercy is in the earth, and that victory belongs to the children of God. And for this, dear God, we give you praise. Oh God, we bless your name. Oh God, we worship your name. Oh God, we magnify your name. Oh God, we praise you, for you are good. You are kind. You are long-suffering. Oh God, you are all-knowing. And Father, we thank you. We magnify you. Oh, we stand on your word in the name of Jesus. And we declare and decree, dear God, it is so in the name of Jesus. And Father, hallelujah, we lay before you, dear God, our request in the name of Jesus that is being called up, Lord God, in the midst of what's going on in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord God, for the Pierce grandsons in the name of Jesus. I pray, dear God, for Devin. God, open a door in the field of engineering in the name of Jesus. Father, I ask you, oh God, for a miracle in blood issues in the name of Jesus. Oh God, brain tumors in the name of Jesus be gone. Hallelujah, shrink brain tumors. Father, let there not even be a brain tumor. Oh God, when they get through examining, may they declare, we don't know what it is. We don't know what it was. Ah, God, Father, we ask, Lord, for knowledge and wisdom for those, Lord God, that are giving care to the elderly in the name of Jesus. Give them understanding. Download what's going on in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, and we pray in the name of Jesus for grandchildren, grandchildren everywhere in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, hallelujah. Grab our grandchildren and bring them into the understanding of you in the name of Jesus, that they would turn to you in the name of Jesus. We pray, Lord God, for childhood diabetes in the name of Jesus. God, you are a miracle worker. You can turn it in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we pray, Lord God, even for students. Students, Lord, that are trying to learn virtually. Father, I ask you in the name of Jesus, students in their studies, give those doing virtual learning, give them motivation and give the instructions, discernment. Give the instructors, give, Lord God, the teachers discernment to the learning styles of students that are doing virtual learning. Father, may they be sensitive to the fact, oh God, that the attention span is waning in the name of Jesus. Oh God, and give the instructor understanding in what to do to grab that student's mind and bring it back so that they can learn. Father, I pray for the atmosphere that the child is learning in. God, I ask you, let there be peace in their atmosphere. Let it be an atmosphere of learning in the name of Jesus. Not where it's an atmosphere where everything else is going on, but a peaceful place where they can learn in the name of Jesus. Protect, Lord God, our college students in the name of Jesus. Oh, God. I speak a miracle, dear God, over double vision in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, hallelujah, what the doctors may not understand, God, you understand and you know. Oh, Father, I ask you, dear God, to open the doors, oh, God, of employment opportunity for those, Lord God, that are looking for specificity in employment. God, you can do that thing. Oh God, I pray for Hannah and Alexandra, Jaden and Lennox. Oh God, I pray, Lord God, for those that are contemplating career moves. Give them direction in the name of Jesus. Oh God, I pray for Sabrina and Garfield. I pray, Lord God, for marriages. Marriages that are struggling. Marriages, Lord God, that are building. Marriages that are just beginning in the name of Jesus. I ask you, dear God, hallelujah, give us wisdom and understanding in how, Lord God, to operate in this season of our marriages. Father, I pray, Lord God, for Sierra and for Gabby. In the name of Jesus, I pray, God, for cases, court cases that are still open, been open, Lord God, for years. Father, cases that have been open for months. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to bring, Lord God, closure. And may the closure, Lord God, be in the favor, Lord God, of the child of God. I pray, Lord God, for Sister Jackie. I pray, Lord God, for Cheryl Mason. I pray, Lord God, hallelujah, for the Gilchrist family. I pray, dear God, strength, Lord, for Deacon Gilchrist in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, you are a healer. Father, I pray, Lord God, for the Matthews family, Wayne Sr., Angela, Wayne Jr., Isaiah, Michael, Joshua, Ray. Rachel, Sydney Cross, oh Father, for Cece and Naya, oh God, for restoration of your people. I pray for souls, Lord God, that are seeking your face. I pray for Mr. Jones, for Lynn, for Tisha, Denisha, oh God, Mother Catherine Brown, oh God, I pray for Janae, Taylor, oh God, I pray for healing, oh God, Carol, Bob, Deb, and Joe, Kijan, Evangelist Betty, Brandon, oh God, I pray, Lord God, for those that are trying to meet necessary needs, rent, Lord God, mortgages, groceries, medications, Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, I ask you, hallelujah, to open up the windows of heaven, Father, in the name of Jesus, you already speak a blessing over the tither, over the giver, Father, I ask you to meet the need of your people, those, Lord God, that are tithing, those that are sowing. Father, in the name of Jesus, you promised that you will rebuke the devourer for their sake. God, your word shall not go out. Oh God, your word, Lord, in the name of Jesus, shall come to pass. God, I pray for healing for Brandon, Pastor Surrey, Tommy, Sister Curry, Kay. Oh God, for unsaved husbands and wives. Oh God, I pray for Pam, Sister Doris, Indira Brown, Amir Huggins, James and Jeffrey. Oh God, Mother Gay and Brother Gay. Open, Lord God. Hallelujah. For Mother Brown, I pray, Lord God, for Sister Doris, Karen, Sister Liz, Sister Michelle, James Anderson, Mother Patterson. Oh God, Marion Perkins, Cedric, Franklin family, Pastor Sabrina Ellis, the Reed family. Father, in the name of Jesus, those that are grieving this morning, Father, hallelujah, oh God, give peace that surpasses all understanding, in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord God, for Sister Trina, Sister Andrea, Sister Tisha, oh God, for those dealing with kidney issues, oh God, Sister Katie Davis, Father Giovanni Career, Elijah Carson, Zion Smith, Edward Hoskins, Maj and the girls, Marcus Loving, Terrence Morris, Tay Palmer, Dora Sam, oh Carla Gurnell, Sky Frost, Scar Frost, those that are dealing with arthritis and bursitis, Stephen Clark, Father Carolyn Bolin, District Elder Sylvester and Minister Kara Alls, Bonita Cheryl, Deborah Carmita Kim, Mother Susie Ross, Ha God, Michelle Jones, Harry and Cora Evans, Keel God, Tika Tig, hallelujah, Robert Johnson, Baby Judah, oh God, heal, Mother Audrey Woods, Leona Morell, abused and violent children and violated children and women, oh God, Lindsay Ballard, Errol and Addis Joseph, Mother Gertha and Brother Lorenzo Walker, autoimmune diseases, Natasha and the girls, Mrs. Long, oh God, Cheryl Rose, oh God, we pray for LaRon Rainey, God, we pray, Lord God, for Bishop and Lady Golder and family, Jean Thompson, Lorna, in the name of Jesus, oh Father, hallelujah, we pray, Lord God, for those that are getting ready to go through surgery, in the name of Jesus, God, give peace of mind, we pray for Sandy and P, Kathy and Blakely, Kathy Blakely, Brother Tyree Coleman, oh God, we pray for those that are dealing with kidney disease and renal failure, Diane and Angela Matthew, oh God, Bell and Norm family, Father, we claim the victory in the name of Jesus, we declare and decree, Lord God, that it is so, even over the McKnight, hallelujah, Amani Jones, God, we pray for those that are sick, oh Father, you are a healer of all sickness and disease, those that are dealing with diabetes and blood pressure, Father, in the name of Jesus, we declare declare, Lord God, is there anything too hard for you? Is there anything impossible for you? There is nothing, Lord God, too hard. There is nothing, God, impossible. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, even for back pains, oh God, for Bishop Geese, in the name of Jesus, the Walton family, the homeless, Lord God, the body of Christ to unite, lung issues, blood issues, oh God, for Sister Emma Whiteworth, Father, Mother Harrison and Elder Harrison, arthritis, in the name of Jesus, we claim the victory, Father, in the name of Jesus. And I pray, Lord God, for those that are on the Facebook Live, hallelujah, praying, those that are on the prayer line, in the name of Jesus, the victory belongs, hallelujah, to the child of God. And God, we declare and decree that it is so, in the name of Jesus. And God, we put a praise on it. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. You did it again. Hallelujah. You did it again. You did it again. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, I thank you. God, we give you praise. God, we bless your name. Hallelujah. You are a wonder working wonder, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for continuing to heal. Bring, Lord God, a miracle, even in the body of Evangelist Sherry Brogdon and Elder Brogdon, in the name of Jesus. We declare the victory in the name of Jesus. We declare the victory in the name of Jesus. Even for the Anderson family, even those that are dealing with alcoholism, oh God, drug addiction, we claim the victory in the name of Jesus. And it is so, God. And it is so. And it is so. And it is so. In the name of Jesus.